In this video, I'm going to show you how I use and how I set up my trader workstation. You will learn how to set up hotkeys, time and sales, level 2, watch lists, charts, and more. Make sure to download Trader Workstation from the Interactive Brokers website and open the program. If you're not sure where to download it, I'll post a link down below in the description. If this is your first time opening this program, then you will have a default setting like this. We're actually going to create a new one, and I'll show you what I use and how I optimize mine for trading stocks and options. Click on the plus sign to create a new layout. Enter a name of what you want to call the layout and click create. You'll notice a green color around the border and a lock that is unlocked. This will allow you to add and move things around. For example, let's add a level 2. You can also move and resize this to wherever you want in this space. Once you are done with placing it wherever you want, then you just click the lock icon and save. If the layout is locked, then you won't be able to move or resize any of the windows that you added. You will need to click on the lock to unlock it so that you can move things around. I'll show you another way to create your layout, and it's what I actually use since I have multiple screens. I like to move the windows out of this layout into another screen or just out of this layout so I can have more space. To do this, make sure the platform is locked. Adjust the size of this window like this. Once you've made it smaller, hit the unlock icon again. Once it's unlocked, drag the level 2 out of the platform and into any screen that you want. Just make sure the trader workstation remains unlocked until you have finished setting up your layout. Once it's done, click the lock button and hit save. The first thing we're going to do is click file and then click global configuration. Any changes you make in global configuration will affect all your windows and layouts at once. This will save you a lot of time instead of changing the settings for each one. Click API and click precautions. Checkbox bypass order precautions for API orders. The reason for that is whenever you place an order, the system will automatically send you a pop-up message that's asking you for permission to submit the order. Trading is all about speed. You don't want any interruptions or any delays when you're trying to enter or exit a position. By checking this box, it will disable the message confirmation from popping up. That means that when you press submit button, your order will be submitted right away. The next one we're going to change is under display. Click on ticker row. Make sure to uncheck display tick dots instead of colored prices. This is for the time and sales window. By default, it will only display these little red and green arrows beside the price. It's much easier to see the prices being colored compared to the default settings. Close this out and click new window. Click portfolio, resize it, and place it anywhere on your screen. Portfolio will show your daily profit and loss, your account balance, and your daily open and closed positions. Let's add the next one. Click new window. Go to order management and click orders. This will show you the orders that you submitted that are open and closed. That way it's easy to see which orders have been filled. You can also add another tab to see your trades and summary. The next one we're going to add is order entry. Click new window and click order entry. Order entry allows you to submit orders very quickly. On the top left corner is where you would put the ticker symbol of what you want to buy or trade. Then click either buy or sell depending on your position. You then enter the quantity right beside it. Next to quantity is what type of order you want to submit. For example, limit order, market order, or stop order. If it's a limit order, you can enter a specific price of what you want to buy it at or by pressing the bid, mid, or ask price. I leave day as it is and keep it to adaptive. Adaptive is an algorithm that will try to get you the best price possible. Hit submit when you want to send out your order. The next one we're going to add is the option chain. Click new window and under option tools, click option chain. This is where you can find the option contracts for the stocks that you're looking at. You'll notice that there is a green colored chain on the top bar. When you click on it, you can actually group windows together, meaning if I group this option chain with the order entry and I press on a contract that I want to buy, it will automatically get added onto the order entry where I could then place a trade. This will save you some time. Your option chain might look a bit different from mine, and that's because I deleted a few columns that I don't need. To do that, right click on the column you want to remove and click delete. For my option chain, I only kept the bid, ask, volume, and open contracts. And that's because that's all I need to know based on how I'm trading. This also makes the option chain look cleaner. On the top left corner is where you pick the expiration dates for the contracts. Click on the right or left arrow to see more expiration dates. If you don't see the date that you are looking for, click the right arrow and go to the very end and click more. You will then see a drop-down menu of all the expiration dates available. Once you see the contract that you want to buy, click on it and it will automatically be added onto your order entry. In just a little bit, I'll show you how to submit orders much faster by using hotkeys. The next window we're going to add is a chart. Click new window and under general tools, click chart. Top left corner is where you put the ticker symbol and beside it is where you could change the time frame. For example, if you want to look at the hourly candles, use your mouse scroll to zoom in and out. You can also use the up and down arrow keys in your keyboard to zoom in and out. Now we're going to add the level 2. Click new window and under general tools, click market depth level 2. Level 2 shows you what the current bid and asking price is for that ticker symbol. When you first open your level 2, it will look different from mine. Right click on the columns and delete everything except for market maker name, price, and size. To change the color of your level 2 price levels, click on this gear icon and click settings. Click on the colors tab And here you can change the text and the background colors. Once you're done, make sure to hit apply and click OK. The next window we're going to add is time and sales. Time and sales will show you orders that are being bought and sold. The color green represents orders being filled on the asking price, and red represents orders being filled on the bid price. The white color represents orders being filled between the bid and ask price. The next window we're going to add is the watch list. Click new window and under general tools, click watch list. Type the ticker symbol that you want to watch, and if you group your watch list with the other windows, then you could just click the ticker symbol on your watch list and it will automatically be added onto the other windows. This can also save you some time. There's one last thing that we have to add. I saved the best for last. The last window that we're going to add is called Book Trader. This is a game changer and it will help improve your trading dramatically. I use this for options trading. Click New Window and under General Tools, click Book Trader. Book Trader is basically hotkeys. You press a button and it will execute a trade based on your settings. Click Configure and make sure you have unchecked Display Auto Scroll after scrolling. The reason for this is when we're using the Book Trader, there is a countdown that pops up and it could get distracting. It's best to just leave it off. Now let's set up our buttons. Beside where it says Armed, click on the settings icon and this is where we can start editing the buttons. I'll go through my settings and you can copy it or make your own. The first thing you want to do is click on a button and click Edit. The first button I like to have is Buy Market Order. When I press this button, it will fill my order at market price. I use this to get into position, especially if it's moving fast. Make sure that the option contract you are trading has a tight spread so you don't get filled at a bad price. For select action, choose buy. Now, you can create your own name for this button by unchecking the generate label and typing your own. Or you leave that checked and the system will automatically create a name for your button. You can also change the colors of your buttons. I just set mine to green because it represents a buy order. For the action, choose buy since this is a buy order. For size, I just leave it to default because I want to be able to change my contract size. You can set it to absolute if you want to buy only a specific number of contracts or shares, or you can choose available. For the order type, pick market since this button is for a market order. For TIF, time in force, leave it to day. For destination, I just leave it to default. For target order, attach order type, I put none. For the attach order, I also put none for all three. You can use this if you want to preset a stop loss. I like to manually close up my positions if I need to by using another button. Make sure to put a checkbox on transmit the order instantaneously. Once you're done, click OK. The next button we're going to click is sell market order. This is my emergency button. I use this if I need to bail out of my position as soon as possible. To set this up, click new or edit an existing button. For the select action, pick sell. And again, you can create your own name for this button or let the system create one for you. Change the background color to red so that you know that this is a sell order. For the order type, pick market order. TIF, just leave it at day. Destination, keep it at default. And for the rest, set it all to none unless you want this preset a stop loss. Don't forget to checkbox transmit the order instantaneously and click OK. The next button we're going to create is a buy limit order. Create new button. For select action, choose buy. I put buy limit for the name and green for the background. The action is set to buy. The size is default. For order type, pick limit order. For the limit price, choose asking price with an offset of 2%. This means that I'm willing to pay for the contracts up to 2% higher than the current asking price. You can choose whatever offset you want. The offset is to make sure that my orders get filled. I use this button to get into a position. I leave the rest of the settings the same as the previous buttons. Click transmit order instantaneously and click OK. The next button we're going to create is a sell limit order. This is what I use when it's time to take profits. Choose sell for select action. I put sell ask as the name since we will be selling on the asking price. Change the background color to red because it's a sell order. For action, choose sell. For size, I just leave it at default. For order type, choose limit order. For limit price, choose ask and put 0.00 on the amount offset. The rest of the settings will be the same as the others. The next button is close position. They usually have one made for you by default. This button will close out any open positions that you may have. The next button is called cancel. This will cancel any pending orders that you may have. Let's say, for example, you submitted an order and it hasn't been filled yet. If you press this button, it will cancel the order. You should have one already made for you, but if you don't, then just click new and select action. Choose cancel all orders and press OK. The last two buttons that I have are sell limit orders for selling on the bid, each with a different offset percentage. I use this for taking profits or if I want to close my positions and I'm willing to sell on the bid price. For select action, choose sell. I named it sell limit with a slightly different shade of red so that it's different from all the other sell buttons. For action, choose sell. Leave the size to default. Pick limit for the order type. Limit price is the bid and 1.5% offset. Copy the rest of the settings like the rest. Checkbox transmit instantaneously and click OK. The last button I have is the same setup except the offset is different. Now, once you have all your buttons set up, click apply at the bottom of the page and click OK. If you want to change the book trader's title name, go back to global configuration and click on display, click on settings, and change the title bar text to whatever you want to call your book trader. If you found this helpful, please subscribe to my channel so I can create more content. Thank you.